Greetings all, it's the Devious Monkey here. Guess where I am? I'm about to cross the threshold to keep the shit of life back here. Yes, obviously I'm at Pleasure House Point. Very much in need of a nice, relaxing walk in the wonderful weather. I just made 28 phone calls. Yes, 28. And I'm done. I'm done until Sunday. For now, screw work. It is gorgeous out. It's in the 80s. There's a nice breeze. It's so warm though. It's not like a cold breeze. Like the other night when I went for that walk, I didn't realize it was in the 50s and I was out there in a t-shirt and I had to walk quickly to get my body heat up because it was freaking cold. So here's the deal. I have shot so much video over the past 3 weeks. Two of those weeks when I was helping my dad, and then a week back here where I was trying not to lose my mind from having to work for a living. So I basically have shot so much stuff that it's incredibly overwhelming. Now, as I was filming the entire time I was at my dad's, I kept saying, I'm probably not gonna post a lot of it because a lot of it is just sort of my thoughts as I was going through the 2 weeks there while I was helping him with his treatments and just, you know, just trying to be there and help him around the house and hang out and talk. I did do a nostalgic sort of tour of where I grew up. So there's a lot of that in there. That's probably the one video you're gonna get out of all the things that I did. Because again, all the other stuff was basically just for me. I'm not gonna, I mean, other than you know that my dad has cancer and that I was home helping him, I'm not gonna go into all the shit that I talked about while I was there filming because it's nobody's damn business. But I definitely wanted to do the nostalgia tour and I will cut that video together this weekend. This is just a quick, I'm back. I've just been busy. I mean, the 2 weeks that I was at home, I knew I wasn't gonna try to post anything because it was nonstop all day long. My dad is a freaking trooper. He's a machine. He's 87 years old. He has cancer and he ran me ragged. I mean, it was ridiculous. And I'm not getting cancer treatment. I mean, unbelievable. So by the end of the night, it was all I could do to make myself go in and shower. And then I just lay there, you know, kind of watching videos, and then I would fall asleep. And he was up before me every day. He was waking me up so that we could get going on our day. And it was earlier every day. But every day I was up like pretty much right around 7 o'clock, we'll just say, to start the day, and went until at least 10 o'clock before I actually like started to wind down. So I was exhausted and he did all that shit and seemed to handle it better than I could. So I've got no excuse. Since I've been back, like this week, I've started walking every day. So at night after dinner, I'm going for a walk because I need to. I definitely realized I needed to after I saw how pathetic I was trying to keep up with an 87-year-old cancer patient. So yes, I'm gonna be doing that on a regular basis now. I'm gonna be stopping and not working all day because I'll be caught up after this weekend. I say I'm caught up, but that it's never happening. I'm always gonna be behind because there's always some dumb shit to do. So I'll deal with that. But for the most part, I should be like ready to go and a little bit more back to normal, so to speak. And then I'll be back on a regular schedule of filming and posting. Not gonna promise every day, but as much as possible. But I can definitely tell you that after getting 3 weeks worth of footage, there's no frickin' way I'm gonna be able to go through that and try to glean out that many videos. And I thought that I was gonna be posting every day this week. I have not had any time. I've been so busy and overwhelmed trying to get work caught up and all that shit. So you ain't getting that either. All right, so now I'm going to stop filming because I actually want to enjoy this walk because it's so pleasant out here. So we'll just kind of go from there. But I definitely needed to get out here and blow off some steam. I also started taking this B100 complex vitamin that I stopped taking last year because I stopped taking everything before my colonoscopy. And my buddy was like, I thought you were taking that all the time because it gave you like super energy. And I go, well, I stopped taking everything. I mean, I wasn't taking ibuprofen, and fuck, I've been doing that every day for like 20 years. So I stopped taking it. But this week I'm like, okay, I got to get that little bit of extra get up and go, and not getting it from sugar and caffeine. So I decided that I was going to start taking that again. Just so happens when I walked in yesterday to get Sudafed, I caught it at the perfect time because it was buy one, get one free. And each bottle is like $30. So I was like, hell yeah, that's serendipity, man. So I got it. I took the first one this morning and I'm pretty full of energy right now. So if you think you need some more energy, maybe try taking a B100 complex vitamin and see what it does for you. Okay, that's it. That's all I'm going to go over right now. I'm back. I'm as sane as I ever was. And life is grand. Don't take it for granted. Go out there and live it to the best of your ability. All right, that's it. That's all I've got for you. I'm back, baby. So keep your eye out for more videos. So that's all you get for today. If you have any comments, questions, or suggestions, leave them down below. As always, thanks for joining me. Be sure to like and subscribe. And remember, kids, forward and up.